If you have understood this, then I can follow it up with another question, which is of very, very similar nature. Let's see whether you are able to crack that. Question is, show that the locus of points, the locus of points such that two of the three normals drawn from them to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax coincide is 27ay square is equal to 4 times x minus 2a cube. Is the question clear? So you have to find the locus of points, let's say that point h comma k, such that two of the three normals drawn from them coincide. That means two of the roots from m1, m2, m3 are the same. Very, very similar to the approach that we had taken. So guys, this time it is something like this. It touches and goes back. So let's say this is your m1 and here m2 and m3 would be the same. Okay. It could be this way as well. I mean, I'm not denying that. It could not be this way. It could be this way as well. It could come like this, touch, and go back. That means this is your the two roots, m1 equal to m2, and this is your m3. If done, let me know. So guys, here the things will not change. We are looking at the same scenario, right? So h comma k will satisfy the equation of the normal like this, right? Okay. And again, let's say I call this term as f of m. This is your f of m. Okay. F dash m, again, if you put it to 0, you get two roots, alpha and beta. And you know both are negative of each other. Okay. So in this case, what will happen? This is your alpha and this is your beta. Or it can happen, this is your alpha and this is your beta. In both the situations, you would realize that f of alpha into f of beta would be equal to 0. Isn't it? Because either the value of the function at beta is 0 or the value of the function at alpha is 0. Correct? So if you remember the previous slide, in the previous slide where we talked about less than 0. So if you recall here, when we talked about less than 0, now we are talking equal to 0. And if you're talking equal to 0, it's but obvious that we'll end up the same expression just with an equality sign. So we'll end up 27ak square equal to 4 times h minus 2a cube. Correct? Isn't it? Yes or no? Yes or no, guys? And then we generalize this. It becomes 27ay square is equal to 4 times x minus 2a cube. Is it clear? Any questions so far? So please ask me if there's any questions so far. Atmesh, Rohan, Lalita, Snigdha. Okay. Next, we are going to talk about circle through co-normal points. Circle through co-normal points. So let me ask this as a question to you. If three normals are drawn from an external point alpha comma beta to the parabola y square is equal to 4ax, then prove that the equation of the circle passing through the co-normal points, passing through the co-normal points, is given by x square plus y square minus 2a plus alpha times x minus beta by 2y equal to 0. Excellent question. So what do we need to prove over here is that from an external point alpha comma beta, this is your alpha comma beta, when you're drawing normals to this parabola y square is equal to 4ax, which meets the normal at a, b and c, then if you pass a circle through it, one thing that you would have observed that this circle is passing through origin, this circle passes through origin. So that's why I have drawn a diagram in such a way that I'm made to pass it through the origin also. So prove that the equation of the circle is this. First, prove that it will pass through origin. That is most important. Step before generalizing once more. Okay. See, Rohan. In the previous problem, in the previous slide, we had talked about f alpha, f beta less than 0. Correct? So that there are three distinct real values of m. Correct? Now, in this case, what is happening? Alpha and beta are what? Alpha and beta are the points of maxima and minima of the function because they are the roots of the derivative of the function equated to zero, right? Correct. So, alpha and beta should be such that, in this case, it would be such that the value of the function at beta would be zero. You can call beta to be a repeated root. Okay. So, you can see in this situation number one and in both situation number two, the value of the function at beta is becoming zero. F of beta is becoming zero here. Here, f of alpha is becoming zero. Because to have two real and equal roots, it must touch the x-axis. It must touch the x-axis. So that is what is happening over here. So when it is touching, it is creating repeated roots over there, right? So whatever is the root of f dash m, the same would be the root of f of m. Okay, so f of alpha into f of beta, one of them would be zero. I don't know which one of them, but one of them would be zero. That's why the product would be zero. So I just used the previous result. So instead of inequality sign, I put a equal to sign, and therefore I got the locus. Is that clear, Rohan? So here, guys, let me help you with this. Let's say A is basically corresponding to that slope, which is M1. Or let's say this point A is AM square comma minus 2AM1. Remember, T is related to M as this relation. So T and M are negative of each other. Okay. So let's say point B is AM2 square minus 2AM2. Point C is AM3 square minus 2AM3. Okay. And let's say point B, which I don't know what it is right now, I'm just calling it as AM4 square minus 2AM4. Okay. So what I'm saying here is that the circle is cutting the parabola not only at those points where it is where the co-normal points are getting formed, but also at some fourth point. Now, how did I know that first? First of all, how do I know that it's cutting at the fourth point? It's very obvious. It's very obvious that if you generalize, if you write the equation of any circle, we usually write it like this, correct? Okay. And if you try to solve the parametric equation of this parabola, if you try to simultaneously solve these two, okay, and you replace your x with am square, then this is what we get. Right, and this is clearly a fourth degree expression. This is clearly a fourth degree expression in M. Okay, so this is a fourth degree, or you can say a biquadratic equation in M, biquadratic expression in M. That means four routes are possible for this. That means a circle will cut the parabola definitely at four points. And let's say the roots of this equation are M1, M2, M3, M4. Okay. These are basically your co-normal points. So these first three, that is M1, M2, M3, they are nothing but they are associated with the slope of the normal at the co-normal points. Now, what is M4? That is what we have to find out. Okay. Now, we have already seen in our previous concept that the sum of the algebraic sum of the normals drawn at these co-normal points will always be zero, isn't it? So from an external point, if I draw three normals to the parabola, the sum of the slope of these three normals will always be zero. This we have seen as a property, correct? So here also, if you see the sum of the roots, that is M1, M2, M3 plus M4, what will be that? That will be minus of b by a, right? And b is the coefficient of m cube. So if you see, there is no m cube term. That means zero m cube term is there. So it will become 0 by a square, which is again 0. Correct. Which implies this term was already 0. This term was already 0. And adding m4 will also giving you 0. That means m4 is also 0. Correct. If M4 is 0, then you can see that this point here would be A into 0 square minus 2A into 0. That means my circle will definitely pass through the origin. That means it is cutting the parabola not only at the co-normal points A, B, C, but also at a fourth point, let's say D. This D, which happens to be your origin. So far clear, guys? No problem in understanding this. Correct? Now, if your circle is passing through origin, that means if the circle is passing through origin, that means C term in the circle would be 0. That means your circle would actually be of the form x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy equal to 0. The C term would be 0 in the circle. Correct. So if I remove this C term from here, this C term, if it goes off, then you can see that you will be getting something like this. Let me write it in some other color, let's say blue. Then you get something like a square m to the power 4 plus 4a square 2ag m square minus 4fm equal to 0. Okay. Take an m common. And you get am cube plus 4a 2ag m minus 4af equal to 0. Now, we clearly note that this m equal to 0 that is coming from here is corresponding to the origin. It is corresponding to this fellow. Correct. That means this equation is the one which is corresponding to m1, m2, m3. Okay. If you want, you can drop a factor of m also from here. Drop a factor of a also from here. So that means am cube 4a plus 2g m minus 4f equal to 0. This will be responsible for giving you the roots m1, m2, m3. m1, m2, m3. Okay. This was responsible for the root m4. Are you getting this point? Slightly heavy concept, but if you understand this, things will be fine for you. Okay, now what I can claim here is that the original equation whose roots was m1, m2, m3, which was actually am cube plus 2a minus alpha m plus beta equal to 0, this also has roots m1, m2, m3. Correct? That means these two equations are identical. These two equations are identical, correct? And if they're identical, I can compare the coefficients of m cube, m and constants on both the sides. Okay? So if you compare the coefficient of m on both the sides, we can say 4a plus 2g is equal to 2a minus alpha. That means 2g is equal to minus 2a minus alpha. Okay. So g we obtained. Similarly, minus 4f is equal to beta. So 2f is equal to minus beta by 2. So 2f also we obtained. So the required equation of the circle, which is x square plus y square plus 2gx. So plus 2gx. Plus 2fy plus 2fy plus c. C is already 0. It would be this, correct? And if you simplify this, it becomes the required equation that we need. This is going to be your answer. Okay. So I think it matches with this equation. Yeah. It matches with this equation. So all of you can see over here. I just repeat the process once again so that everybody understands this clearly. This is quite a difficult concept actually. So first of all, I had to find out the equation of a circle which passes through the co-normal points. Correct. So what I did is I took the equation of any general circle. Any general circle like this. Okay. And try to solve it with the equation of the parabola. Okay. And I got a biquadratic equation. Okay. Now, biquadratic equation will have four roots. M1, M2, M3, M4. Correct. Out of that, three roots are the ones which are belonging to the co-normal points. So that will be 0. That means the fourth root, that is M4, that will also be 0. Right? Once I got the fourth root as 0, that means the fourth point through which the circle passes is definitely origin. Correct? That makes my C also 0. That makes my C also 0. That means the circle will be of this nature. That means my circle will be of this nature. Correct? And if C is 0, the new equation becomes this. If I take M common, it becomes this. So either M could be 0 or this expression could be 0. Correct? M equal to 0 corresponds to M4. So forget about it. The other cubic equation which is left, that corresponds to M1, M2, M3 as the roots. So I'm talking about this fellow. Correct? So this should be same as the original equation of the conic section or of the parabola from where M1, M2, M3 roots were. Whose roots were M1, M2, M3. So these two should be identical. So if they are identical, I just compared their coefficients here. I got the value of 2g, I got the value of 2f, and I then substituted it in the equation and I got my answer.